Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. I'm Darren the Delivery Driver, also known as Abdul Muxin. And then on this channel, I give you the tips, tricks, and inside scoop to make you the most profitable driver. If you like making money, being on the road, and a path to financial freedom, then join the grind by hitting that like button, smashing that subscribe, and leaving your comments down below. In this video, what I'm going to go over with you is, if possible, what orders you should never accept and which ones you should reject. Can I ask you a question? What's the most important thing when you're on the road? Yeah, I know. Many people may say, my vehicle. And of course, you should take in consideration your vehicle, the amount of petrol you put in, avoiding repair costs, and trying to make the most of your time if you're on the 1 hour insurance plan. Others may say, pay, because a lot of us are doing this to take care of our families, to pay our bills, and maybe some are just doing it to make just a little bit of extra cash. What if I told you that there's something more important than your vehicle and your pay? In my opinion, I would say that thing is your time, because I don't want you wasting your time. And hence, that's the reason why, if you're not subscribed yet, you need to hit that subscribe button so you can get updated on the most important things in regards to the gig economy, your side hustle, your full-time hustle. And I also help people make the most avenues for passive income. So the reason why I would say time is because I don't want you guys wasting your time, because we're trading the fact to be self-employed and take advantage of our time, so that we're trading to do Uber Eats, Just Eat, or Deliveroo for our time. So we don't want to waste it. We want to make the most money we can and maximize our time in return for the money that we're working to make. So today, what I want to show you is some examples of some orders, so that which ones you should reject and which ones you should accept, so that you're not wasting your time and you're making the most best decisions and you're maximizing your avenues to make profits. So here we have our first order, which is from Subway, and it's lunch rush. This is around 12 p.m. and it's £3.47. So how we would evaluate this is the time of the day. You have to take in consideration, are people on their lunch break, or like all these things. You have to take in factors into consideration when thinking about this, that how far am I gonna go? Do I have anywhere to park? You know, how long will this restaurant possibly take? You need to take that in consideration for the first one. Now for this second order, it's from Nando's, and the price is a little bit more than the first one. You gotta take in consideration that it's almost if not closer, about the same distance as the one that's less pay. And you know, there more than likely won't be a huge lunch rush or anything at this place. So take that in consideration for the second one. Okay, and the third order that we got is from Five Guys. And it's a lunch rush. It's the most pay out of the three, so it's about £4.15. But the area where you're going is a bit further than the other two. So when you're thinking about this, you got to take in consideration the time of day it is, what you think that will possibly be going on at the restaurant, if it has a drive-through, if it has customers that's going to be inside that maybe work around that area. You have to take all this stuff into consideration. Is it a tourist place, this or that? So with that being said, I would reject the Subway, not just because it's the least paying one, but because the area where it's going, you know? The one that I would accept would be the Nando's order, because usually they, like the type of food that they cook, even though they have customers that can be inside, but the type of food that they cook, it wouldn't take that long for them to have it prepared and ready for you. Just to go in and swoop it. It's the one that's the middle amount of money, but where it's going, it's not a difficult place to get to. It's off one of the main roads, just a turn, boom, done. You're delivering to someone who's at work, more than likely, because it's a Mercedes-Benz place. But the one I would reject also as well would be the Five Guys one, because you got to go where the Five Guys is located. You got to go all the way down, and then you got to go all the way far outside. You have to maybe even take partially a motorway to get to that area. So I would reject the Subway and that one, and the Five Guys, and I would accept the one for Nando's because where it's going, the amount of time it possibly would take, and that's what I would do. All right, guys, so now we're on to another example. We're here on Uber Eats. This order we have is from Burger King, And wow, Uber Eats actually shows you where it's going. It's not too far. So actually, in all honesty, I probably would accept this order, because it just depending where you are, like I reside close to the Burger King, so it would only take me a little bit of time to get there. By the time I get there, I think they automatically start making it, because Uber automatically starts making the order when it goes through the system. By the time I get there, it'd be ready. It's going a short distance. And then I'm also in another, delivering to an area where there's loads of restaurants and things like that. So it'd be just easy, like probably one after the other. So this is an order to accept. Now let me go on to an order that you would reject on Uber. And the main reason for rejecting an order on Uber, whether you know how far it's going or not, is the price. Because sometimes there's no boost, and it's just not worth it when there's no boost to do orders at, you know, whatever time of the day that it is on Uber. Usually Uber customers, they usually tip sometimes, but you just gotta be smart with your time and knowing which orders to accept.
I really wanted to go over with you guys is to not be afraid to reject orders. Like, you can't get fired for your acceptance rates, and there's no penalty upon you for rejecting orders. So just be smart, like, you know, just factor in all possibilities and things like that, and don't be afraid to reject orders, because I know there's some drivers who just accept every order and just do whatever. And I have a clear example about the video that's going to be linked above of accepting every order, and it's pretty much not a good idea. Also, what I wanted to tell you guys is that this video, we're going to show a business. This is sponsored by Mon Musk. This is a perfume company. They're based here in the UAE, but they ship to the United Kingdom, and they ship here in the UAE as well. So you got international shipping. You guys should definitely check them out. Let me go ahead and show you the perfume. This is the perfume here. This one is Arabi, the Arabi. Smells terrific. Absolutely smells terrific. What I'll do is I'll show you guys. This is their website. You can check out the website. You can also follow them on Instagram. And yeah, just check out the perfume. All right, guys. So yeah, that's pretty much it. This video was about being smart with your time while being on the road, and which orders to reject and which ones to accept. I hope this really helps you out. And yeah, guys, again, just, yeah, really put a lot of emphasis on this. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, give it a like, leave your comments down below, because it really helps out with the YouTube algorithm. So yeah, guys, that's pretty much it. Hope you like it. Assalamu alaikum, rahmatullahi wabarakatuh.